Hey everyone, welcome to the session by Intellipaat. As we all know it, Python is widely used to drive a data-driven business to success in these days. Many companies like Amazon, Facebook, Google, and thousands of other IT firms are making use of Python on a day-to-day basis, guys. And in today's session, we will quickly check out how we can set up and install Python on a Windows environment. Well, before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the Intellipaat's YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to stay up to date with all of the content that our subject matter experts are putting out for you guys. And on that note, let's quickly check out the agenda for this session. Firstly, we'll take a quick introduction to Python. Second, we'll check out where Python is used. Followed by this, we'll take a step-by-step walkthrough to get Python installed on your Windows machine. And fourth, we'll actually verify if the installation went well by running a quick demo code, guys. And if you have any questions or comments regarding this, make sure to head to the comments section and let us know. And on that note, if you guys are interested in an end-to-end course certification in Python, Intellipaat provides the Python certification course training, which will help you master the language and earn a certificate in the same. So without further ado, let's begin with the session. So what is Python, guys? Well, when you come to think about it, Python has been everywhere, right? So it's a language which came about in the 1980s and took the world by storm when it overtook Java as the most popular programming language there is today, guys. So Python is a very easy to learn language. It is interpreted, it is object-oriented, and it is a high-level programming language, guys. So basically, since it's easy to learn, again, there is a lot of high-level code written in it. So this makes program maintenance very easy and you wouldn't have to work on that harder. And then pretty much modularity and code reuse as well, because there are a lot of modules in Python that you can just pretty much invoke and then start using directly. And that makes the life of a coder very easy, in my opinion, guys. And third, Python has been open source, and I'm pretty sure it always will be, guys. So one perk of it being open source is that it is free to access, but the second biggest perk is that it has a wonderful community which has thousands and millions of learners who are enthusiasts, professionals, subject matter experts, software architects, and so much more, guys. So number four is pretty much the number of libraries and the number of frameworks which Python supports. So everything from your simple Hello World program all the way till achieving artificial intelligence, people prefer Python for that. And pretty much all of the Python developers that I have met love to work with Python, guys. So you might be wondering where Python is used. Well, Python is used in YouTube, people at Netflix, Instagram, Spotify, Amazon, Facebook. That's the new logo of Facebook, by the way, and so much more. Well, I could not think of an idea of fitting all of the images of the firms in just one slide. So I had to break it down to the top people and the top contenders where Python is just present everywhere, guys. Well, if you're watching this YouTube video, well, Python is working, artificial intelligence is working on your mobile right now. Because YouTube, when using Python, is giving you active and fresh recommendations of what you should watch, considering the past experiences of what you have watched and so much more. So it's pretty much learning what you watch and then making suggestions based on that, guys. And at Netflix as well. And pretty much even in Netflix, guys. So Netflix is the world's best streaming service as of now, per se. I mean, it's in a couple of people's opinion, but for sure. Because they use technology at every single level. They use artificial intelligence to map out what TV shows are liked by people of what region and so much more. I mean, I just gave you a very simple example, but they actively change the thumbnail of their TV shows and movies just based on your requirement, your favorite actors, actresses, and so much more. Coming to Instagram, they will know what content they have to show to you better. They can show you better advertisements and so much more. Spotify, again, music is the biggest thing the world has ever seen, is a quote which I read very recently, and I sort of agree with the quote. So having that recommendation and that tailor-made feel for you when you listen to music and having this fresh recommendations is one amazing thing. And Spotify, again, Amazon gives you purchase recommendations and so much more. Facebook again, it pretty much knows what you're browsing through the feed and then gives you recommendations based on what you like, and then it will not show you things that you don't like and so much more, guys. So on that note, let us quickly walk you through the procedure of how you can install Python on Windows, guys. It's a very simple and a straightforward process. Now, I've broken it down to a couple of steps and let's go with it together, right? So step one says go to python.org and head to the downloads page, and let's do that side by side, guys. So let me head to the Python website. So it's python.org for the people who are wondering. I'll just go to download here. You can directly click on the link there. there as well. Since we're looking for Windows, Python pretty much detects that it's for Windows. So we already are at the page where we hit the download. So this pretty much forms our second step as well. So let me quickly, save it in the desktop. It's about 25 MB, if I think. Yeah, it's about 25.2 megabytes. This will take a couple of seconds to download. And in the meantime, let's quickly check out what are the next steps in our PowerPoint slide, guys.
A quick info, guys. In case you're interested in doing an end-to-end course certification in Python, Intellipaat provides the Python certification course training, which will help you master the language and earn a certificate in the same. And on that note, let's quickly head back to the session.
So step two is again, click on the download, which we just did. And guys, as of this video being made, Python 3.8.0 is the latest stable version out there. So that brings us to step three, guys. Step three will pretty much be opening the installer and we should be presented with this screen. So let's quickly wait for the download to complete and then we're gonna open up the installation box. Hey guys, that took about a minute to install and we're presented with this screen, which is the installation screen. Just before you hit install now, you can pretty much choose to customize the installation and install it at a place of your desire. Make sure you just click this button which says add Python 3.8 to path. Well, what it basically does is it sets your environment variables and it sets the path variable to Python. So as soon as you hit Python in your command line, you can just start using Python directly, guys. So that's what it does and it would be recommended that you do this. Even if you would not do this, there would be no problem. There are other ways to launch Python and to use it. But if you are a beginner, if you just want to hit Python and then start up with coding, you can pretty much hit Python to path, guys. And you just hit install now. And this will ask me for my admin password because we have to install it as an administrator. So let me quickly type in my administrator password and we can work with it, guys. And I just entered my password. So pretty much it should take about, around 2 or 3 minutes to get the entire setup process done. So in the meantime, let's check out what's step four. Again, step four is check the last option to add it to the path and install. And step five is the important step, guys. So we need to verify that our installation has been successful. So for that to occur, we need to make sure our setup completes. So let's just wait a minute and then we can go ahead with the setup, guys. So guys, now the setup is successful. Let me quickly open up command prompt to verify that it has been installed correctly, guys. So if I go ahead and type in Python there, then pretty much Python console is ready for us. So let's type in a sample code, hello world. And as soon as I go ahead and run this, we have the output, guys. So pretty much, well, as of this moment, Python 3.8.0 is the official stable release of Python. And that's what we've been using, guys. So we can check out another code snippet as well, guys. So let me do A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 3, and so much more, right? So let us create a new variable D and then probably add A and B to it. So let me just quickly do this. We can print D, well, D is 3. Let's multiply, let's create another variable, call it E, multiply D and C. Let us print E. Guys, I'm just doing this to just show you that everything is working fine. So 3 multiplied with 3 is 3 and so much more. To just get out of the console, you will have to type quit followed by parentheses and you're out of there, guys. So this is as simple as installing Python on your Windows, guys. And we just verified it using a simple piece of code as well, guys. But Python has another thing called as idle, guys. So idle is this pretty much interactive Python console that you can go about using. And the shell is actually ready. So we can go about typing again, hello learners, and done. So the Python 3.8.0 works perfectly on the idle shell as well. So this is another way to just verify the installation, guys. So coming back to the presentation, step 7 is again an optional step, but you will get there very soon in case even if you're a beginner or an advanced learner, guys. So install the libraries that you pretty much want. There are many libraries that Python supports and the most popular ones are TensorFlow, NumPy, SkyPy, scikit-learn, pandas, matplotlib, Keras, PyTorch, LightGBM, and so much more. Well, these are machine learning, deep learning oriented libraries that are present on your screen. But then the next step of installing Python is to pretty much install all of the packages and libraries that you want to go work with further on, guys.
A quick info, guys. In case you're interested in doing an end-to-end course certification in Python, Intellipaat provides the Python certification course training, which will help you master the language and earn a certificate in the same. I hope this session was informative for you all. In case if you have any queries, please head to the comment section below and we'll get back to you guys at the earliest. So thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.